want to know to classify land use land cover images, you can check the previous part of this video, that's the part one of this video. You get the link below this video. Alright, so in this video, we're going to be working towards getting the hectares of each classes and getting their percentages, also converting them into graphs and getting their charts, alright, through Excel and putting it in Microsoft. For those that are into research and want to get more layouts and understanding of how to process land cover. Alright, so first thing first, we are going to convert these raster images to vector, alright, to get their hectares. So you could just click on geoprocessing and you see search for tools. Now the tool we are going to be looking for is raster to poly. Raster to polygon. So just type poly and click enter. So you see your raster to poly, you click on it. You can either bring the drop down here or drag it from here. Alright? So I'll just bring this drop down and we're working with classification too. Alright, so it is very important that you put a value that you could identify for each classes right here. So, well, I'll just put the names so I can identify them each. Alright, so name. Alright, save it in a location where you could remember. Very, very important. Alright, so I'll just give my 2019. Alright, _ raster. Or poly, sorry. Polygon. Alright. Let's go. Okay, LULC. Sorry about that. LULC. Okay, so we could uncheck this. Alright, make sure that you have exactly the same thing I'm doing before you click the OK button. So here we go. Alright, so yeah, you can see why it's taking so much time to load, because each of every pixel has been converted to polygon. So while working on this data, make sure you uncheck it so it doesn't slow your system down. So you right click on this and go to the attributes table. Okay, you can see that we are having about 139,000 polygon here. So what you're going to do is, we're going to add a new field. We're going to be adding the area field. This is going to be in double because it's going to have decimal places. So you click OK. Alright, so having this in decimal places, you go to calculate geometry and make sure that your data is projected or else it's not going to work. Click yes. So if you want to now to project your transform your data, you could just go to ActualBox. You want to project it to you want to turn it to projected coordinate system. Go to ActualBox. Under ActualBox, you go to data management tool. Alright, then you go to projection and transformation, and you go to future. So once you get to future, you click on project. Alright. So if you click on project, you drag your data here and you change it to a projected coordinate system. Alright? A projected coordinate system, any of these coordinate systems depending on your location. Alright. So once you've selected anyone in this projected coordinate system, I'll just go to, I think I'll work with UTM Africa. Then Minas and 31 knots. Alright, so once you have this, you click on the OK button. Alright, so mine is projected, so I don't need to do that. You right click on your area here, go to calculate geometry, click on yes, and you change it to hectares, or you could change it to kilometers, depends on what you want. You are just working with hectares, then click OK. Alright, you click yes. This might take a while to load. Alright, so Here we go. These are the hectares in each pixel, alright? So if you click on this pixel, you might not really see the value here until you zoom to layer. It's telling you this is zoom pixel, alright? So let's zoom back. Alright, now, so you're going to click on this drop down button by the side and you click on select all. Or you don't need to do that, alright? So it depends. So you just click on this button by the side, go to export. Once you click export, make sure you select all records. Alright, so you click on this button here. You give it a name you could remember. Very, very important. Give it a name you could remember. I'll put mine in trash, alright? So we're going to be working with 2019. Alright. And make sure this is database table. Give it a name you can remember, database table, right? So you click on save. So I've done that, you click OK. So this might take a while. Alright, you don't need to add this, just click no. So now this step of taking, you're going to do it for all the land is land cover classification you have. And make sure you follow these steps accordingly. Now we're going to be moving to the next page. Alright. Okay, so what we're going to do next is we're going to open our Excel file. Open your Excel file. Alright. So I'm going to group all these based on their names and generate the actual area size of each class. So I'm going to put them in percentage and in chart and also in graph. Alright, so we're going to start with a new document. Click on your file, go to open, browse. Once you click on browse, go to alright. Where were we? Alright, good. So, you go to where you were working on before to load your DBase file. I'm working on training file. So you can change this to DBase file. Click OK. Raster to poly area is what we saved our file as. So once you save that, you click on open. Alright, good. So now, the next thing you're going to do is select all, or you control A, or you, never mind. You click insert, you click on pivot table. You could see pivot table here, or if you're using another version of Excel, you could see somewhere else. Click on pivot table, it automatically selects everything, highlighted from beginning to the end. And you click on OK. Alright, so what you're just going to do is drag name to rows and areas to values. That is giving you the overall data. So just right click on this, copy and paste as a figure value. So we don't alter this. Alright now. So what you're just going to do is highlight all this and go to format, paste all. Okay now, so you can bold this, make that one bold, and this one to be bold. Oh well, we might just leave the styling for that. Alright now, so you can see the total here, automatically summed up, the ground total. Each of the water body, the agricultural land has about 5,502.78 hectares. Bare soil is the largest among all. So there are a lot of bare soil in the soil area. So now to generate the percentage, I'm put percent in brackets, just give it like this. Alright, to generate the percentage, you say equals to this, that's F4, F and 4. Okay? That's the F4, divided by the total.
Yeah.
Okay, and click enter. It gives you this. Now we are not done with that. We're going to do this for the remaining ones, divided by this. Now to just, you can put dollar sign here. Sorry. Put dollar sign for the constant value. Put dollar sign in the middle and click on enter. You can copy this way down. So now if you've done this, highlight all of them and click on percentage. It gives you the percentage of everything. Alright, now so this is the percentage of everything. Water body is the smallest, it's obvious on the study realm of agriculture follows, and beer soy is the largest. Imagine. Alright, now so to generate our chart, what you're just going to do is you can change this one to classes. Class, you can change this one to areas in brackets, hectare. And you can change this one to just percentage. Okay. So now if you have this one in bold, you can increase the size, okay? Alright now. So now if you just want to get the percentage, you can highlight this too in chart. You click on insert and you click on this and you click on this. Okay? That's very cool, right? So now you can change this one to maybe 2008 land use land cover. Alright? And that's cool, right? So now you have everything in chart like this. So you can change the chart if you want. If you want it like this, it's actually cool. Alright, so in our next video, we're going to be teaching you how to create a layout map for land use land cover. How you're going to design a layout map, putting the legends and the scales and all of that. Alright, so check the link below on this video to see the next step. Alright, thanks for watching. Make sure you click on the subscribe button to get more videos. All right.